Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Roadmap to Clear Competitive Exams. My name is Ajay Patil. In this video, I'll be covering the topic analogy. This is the reasoning topic. So basically, you have to find the relationship between the two words or the analogy between the two words. So let us take the example and understand this. Rich is to poor. Then top is to what? So you have to fill in the blank. They'll give you four options A, B, C, D, and you have to choose one among them. Before that, this is the clue that they are giving you. So you have to find the relationship between these two words. What is the relationship? The relationship is opposite in nature. The opposite of rich is poor. So similarly, the word which is going to come here will be opposite in meaning to top. So top ka opposite kya hoga? Bottom. So bottom will be the answer. This is how you have to find the relation between the two words. So this seemed to be a very easy topic, but it is not so. Nowadays the competition is increasing, and in the examination they are giving very confusing words. The questions seem to be very easy, but the options will be very confusing. So in for around 5 to 6 questions, I'll take easy questions and make you understand different concepts or different varieties of questions. And after that, I'll give you some confusing words which had appeared in the previous exams. So let's continue. These are kinds of relationship with examples, instrument and measurement. So thermometer is used to measure temperature, barometer is used to measure pressure, and so on. So pause the video and check all these things, because in analogy you need to have good knowledge base also, because they will be asking antonyms type of questions, synonyms type of questions, instrument and measurements, quantity and unit. So for all these you need to have a good database with you. If you don't know which instrument is used for which what purpose, then you will not be able to solve the question. So second type is quantity and unit. So unit of mass is kilogram, unit of length is meter, unit of energy is joule, and so on. Individual and group. So group of soldiers is called army, and cattle, herd. Group of sheep is flock, and so on. Animal and young ones. Young ones of cow is calf. Young one of horse is pony. Young one of sheep is lamb, etc. Male and female, horse, mare, dog, bitch, son, daughter, gentleman, lady, etc. Individual and class. Monkey belongs to mammal group, man belongs to mammal group, ostrich belong to bird group. So you need to have all the you need to know all those things. Individual and dwelling places. Dog lives in a kennel. Bee lives in a apiary. Lion lives in den, etc. Study and topic. So study of birds is called ornithology. Study of earthquakes is called seismology. Study of plants is botany, etc. Tool and action. So if you want to do sewing, you need needle. If you want to cut, you need knife. If you want to dig, you need mattock. So you need to understand the meaning of all these terms also. Mattock, what is mattock? Many people don't know this. So you need to have the knowledge of this thing. Worker and working place. Chef works in kitchen. Farmer works in field. Pilot works in cockpit. So artist works in theater, etc. Worker and tool. Tool of warrior is sword. Tool of woodcutter is axe, etc. So pause the video, have a look at all these things, understand the terminologies, understand the meaning of the words. So these are the things which had appeared in the previous examinations, and these are the most probable things which would be asked in the upcoming exams also. So make sure that you know at least these words. Continuing, worker and product, farmer, crop, hunter, prey, etc. Product and raw material. Glass is used for prism, is used to build prism. Milk is used to make butter. Fiber is used to make cloth, etc. Part and whole relationship. Nib is a part of pen. Lead is a part of pencil. Kitchen is a part of house, etc. Word and intensity. Anger, rage, wish, desire, sink, drown, etc. Word and synonym. So synonym means meaning of the word. Abode means dwelling. Blend means mix. Assign means allot. Dissipate means squander, etc. Antonym, opposite in meaning. Attack, defend, rich, poor, advance, retreat, best, worst, etc. So pause the video, have a look at all these things, note it down in your notebook, and at least know these words, because these are important words which should appear in the examination. So first category of question, belonging to certain category, novel, book, marathon, question mark. So what you do is pause the video, attempt the question by yourself, and then look into the discussion. So novel is a type of book. Okay, novel is a type of book. Bhagavad Gita is a type of book. Comic books are a type of book. So what is marathon? Marathon is a type of race. So marathon is a type of race. We say 100 meter race is a type of race. It's a type of race. 200 meter is a type of race. Okay. So marathon means long distance race. It's a long distance race. So this is also a type of race. So you have to be very cautious when you find the relationship between these two words. So the exact relation should be replicated in this thing also. Sometimes you will be able to find the relationship between these two words, but you might fail to find the exact relationship between this word and this word. So what people usually do is marathon is a long run race. They might tick option B, and that time it will be wrong. Or marathon runner also. So these are the thing which are little bit confusing. So make sure that you find proper analogy and you apply that for the other word also. Second, opposite in meanings, simple to understand, rich, pauper, cold, hot. Rich ka matlab, the person who has huge money with him. Pauper means the person who doesn't have any money with him. Pauper. So you need to know the meaning of pauper. If you don't know the meaning of pauper, then you will not be able to find the relationship between these two words, and thus you can't make, and thus you can't find the answer, because you don't know the relationship, and you will not be able to find what is the relationship between cold and the other word. So it is opposite in nature. Rich means the person who has huge amount of money, and pauper means the person who doesn't have any money. So cold ka opposite hota hai hot. Type 3 question, definition. One of the stem words is definition of the other. See, starving and hunger. Starving ka stem word hota hai starve. So what is starve? Starve means hunger. So animated ka kya hota hai? Pause the video and answer this question, because many of them will go wrong here. Many of them will tick option A, but option A is wrong. Option B is the correct answer. Animated ka meaning hota hai excited. Cartoon kya hota hai? Cartoon is a type of film or movie where the things are shown in an animated way or excited way. Animated way or excited way. But cartoon itself is not animated. कार्टून का मीनिंग इट्सेल्फ इज नॉट एनिमेटेड, सो मीनिंग ऑफ एनिमेटेड इज एक्साइटेड. लैक ऑफ, टाइप फोर क्वेश्चन, लैक ऑफ, वन वर्ड इंडिकेट्स व्हाट द अदर वर्ड इज मिसिंग, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इलिटरेट एंड नॉलेज. व्हाट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन दीज टू वर्ड्स? इलिटरेट के पास क्या नहीं होता है? इलिटरेट के पास नॉलेज नहीं होता है, सो इट इज शोइंग लैक ऑफ नॉलेज. सो पुअर के पास क्या नहीं होता है? पुअर के पास नहीं होता है मनी. पुअर विल नॉट बी हैविंग मनी, सो द पर्सन हु डजंट हैव मनी इज पुअर. दैट इज वाई द आंसर इज मनी. पार्ट ऑफ ग्रुप, टीम, लोकेशन, एग्जाम्पल डॉग, पैक, फ्लावर, वॉट. सो ग्रुप ऑफ डॉग्स, वॉट डू यू कॉल ग्रुप ऑफ डॉग्स? ग्रुप ऑफ डॉग्स इज पैक. सो वॉट इज ग्रुप ऑफ फ्लावर? ग्रुप ऑफ फ्लावर इज बुके. सो ग्रुप ऑफ फ्लावर इज बुके. पीक, माउंटेन, क्लास, क्वेश्चन मार्क. सो पीक, पीक इज द पार्ट ऑफ माउंटेन. इफ दिस इज द माउंटेन, इफ दिस इज द माउंटेन, देन द टॉप मोस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द माउंटेन इज कॉल्ड पीक ऑफ द माउंटेन. सो दिस पॉइंट इज द पीक ऑफ द माउंटेन. सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस पीक इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द माउंटेन. एंड सिमिलरली क्लास, वॉट इज क्लास पार्ट ऑफ? क्लास इज पार्ट ऑफ स्कूल. स्कूल में बहुत सारे क्लासेस होते हैं, उसमें क्लास इज पार्ट ऑफ द स्कूल. टाइप सिक्स क्वेश्चन, यूज और एक्शन. सो गिल्स, व्हाट आर गिल्स? गिल्स इज द रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन ऑफ फिश. सो थ्रू दिस पार्ट फिश ब्रीद इन वॉटर. सो गिल्स आर यूज फॉर ब्रीदिंग पर्पज. सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट यू शुड नो द मीनिंग ऑफ गिल्स, देन ओनली यू कैन बिल्ड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन गिल्स एंड ब्रीदिंग, एंड लेटर ऑन यू कैन बिल्ड द रिलेशनशिप सीजर एंड समथिंग एंड गेट द आंसर. इफ यू डोंट नो द मीनिंग ऑफ गिल्स, देन यू कांट डू एनीथिंग अबाउट इट. यू हैव टू जस्ट लीव द क्वेश्चन. सो गिल्स आर यूज फॉर ब्रीदिंग. सो वॉट आर सीजर यूज फॉर? सीजर्स आर यूज फॉर कटिंग पर्पस. ओके, मैकेनिक, रिपेयर, सर्जन, वॉट. सो वॉट डज मैकेनिक डू? ही डज रिपेयरिंग वर्क. वॉट डज सर्जन डू? ही डज सर्जरी. सिंपल. सो दीज वेर ऑल सिंपल क्वेश्चंस, द क्वेश्चंस विच आई हैव डिस्कस्ड टिल नाउ. सो लेट्स टेक सम कन्फ्यूजिंग वंस एंड डिस्कस. टिल नाउ आई हैव टेकन सिंपल वंस ओनली टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन वुड बी आस्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन, बट आई डोंट थिंक सो सच ईजी क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्ड इन एग्जाम्स. इफ दे आर आस्किंग सच ईजी क्वेश्चन, देन इट इज योर लक. बट लेट्स बी प्रिपेयर फॉर वर्स्ट थिंग ऑल्सो. लेट्स सी सम हार्डर क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो ईजी क्वेश्चन. इंडिकेटर्स, इट इंडिकेट समथिंग. स्मोक, द इंडिकेशन ऑफ स्मोक, इफ देर इज सम स्मोक, इट इंडिकेट्स दैट देर इज फायर देर. देर इज फायर देर. अगर स्मोक आ रहा है तो वो क्या इंडिकेट करता है? कहीं पर आग है, आग लगी हुई है, इसीलिए वो स्मोक आ रहा है. सो इफ देर इज ब्लड, देन वॉट डज इट इंडिकेट? इट इंडिकेट्स इंजुरी. सो वेन यू एनकाउंटर सम इंजुरी, then you can find blood there. Some confusing analogies. Intimidate, fear. So intimidate ka matlab kya hota hai? Dharna. Intimidate matlab dharna. Fear is also dharna. So this is synonym. You need to understand the meaning of this word, then only you can make the relationship between these two words and find the remaining words or find the required answer. So maintain ka matlab hai maintain karna, to maintain something, to maintain your physique. Satisfaction means santushti. So there is no relationship between these two words. These two words are not the one and the same, so disregard this. Astonish, let's check for C. Sooth, concern. What is sooth? Sooth ka matlab hota hai relaxing effect. So if you go for a massage center and take a massage there, aapko aaram feel hoti hai. So that feeling is called soothing effect. So this is sooth. Concern means you are concerned about something or worried about something. I am concerned about my exams, or I am concerned about the results. So that shows you are worried about something. So these two don't make up. They are not one and the same. That's why disregard this option. Lion, tame. Lion is an animal. Tame is something which is not brave, which is coward. So even these don't make any sense. So disregard this option. So the correct option is B, astonish, wonder. Both are one and the same. Both gives the same meaning. Astonishment, getting surprised. Wonder means also getting surprised. Next example, banish, apostate. So what is the relationship between these two? Banish ka matlab kya hota hai? Banish is the practice of banning someone from the society. Practice of banning someone from the society. What is apostate? Apostate is a person who is banned from the society. So this is the difference. So apostate is the person who is banned from the society. Banish is the practice followed in the society who bans someone in the society. So practice of banning someone in the society is banish. So let's find the similar type of relationship between these words. What is reward? Reward is some prize or some award which you give for the person who does good work. Reward. And traitor. Traitor is nothing but dokebaz, who is a cheat. So these two words don't go together according to the analogy. So disregard this because they are opposite in nature. Renegade. What is the meaning of renegade? Renegade means the person who betrays. Renegade means betraying. Basically, it means betraying. Dhoka dena. So assistance is something different. Assistance is helping somebody with their work. So even these two words don't go together. So disregard that. Remorse. Remorse means to regret. Paschataap hona. To regret. Result means result of something. So even these two words don't go together. Disregard this. Welcome and ally. This is the answer. Welcome means what? You welcome people whom you like, or you welcome your friends, you welcome your relations. Basically, you welcome those people whom you like, and ally is that person whom you like. So welcome is the practice of, it is the practice, and ally is a person, and this analogy satisfies the analogy that we had seen between banish and apostate, and that is why D is the answer. Next question, handcuffs and hands. Handcuffs and hands. So before looking into the answer, please pause the video and attempt the question by yourself and then check. So you can find the difference between your answer and my answer, because these questions are a bit confusing, because you need to find the exact analogy between the words, and that is where many people go wrong here. So please attempt it yourself and then look into the answers. So what are handcuffs? Handcuffs are used for the criminals to restrict their movements of hands. So these are the handcuffs. Bedia, which is put in the hands of criminals to restrict the movements of hands. So what is the thing which we have to see is restriction of the movement of something. Restricting the movement of something. Here we are restricting the movement of hands by using handcuffs. So look at those words which indicates the restriction of movement of something. So paper, kite. So there is no restriction because kite is made of paper and it helps in flying of kite. So this would not be the answer. There is no restriction here. Shoes. Shoes is used for feet. So we wear shoes and there is no restriction. Shoes doesn't restrict our movement of leg. So this is not the answer. Rope, tie. So we tie something, but it doesn't necessarily mean that we are restricting the movement of something. Okay. So this can't be the answer. Leash. What is leash? Leash is the belt which is used in the which is put in the neck of the dog. So if this is the dog, so in the neck of the dog this belt is put so that the movement of the dog is restricted to certain place so that it doesn't move here and there. So leash is used to restrict the movement of dog, and this is the correct analogy. So option A is the answer. Next question, insult, invulnerable. So in who are invulnerable people? Invulnerable people are those people who are powerful, who are from well-to-do families, or who are knowledgeable, who know their basic rights. So what is the analogy between these two words? The meaning is the people who are invulnerable, that is the powerful people, cannot be insulted. So the people who are powerful or invulnerable people cannot be insulted is the analogy between these two words. So let us check for the options. Success, capable. So this is not showing negative relation. That is, the people who are capable will become successful. So this is the direct relationship, and this is not the answer, because we want such an analogy where it satisfies this analogy. That is, the people who are invulnerable cannot be. So the cannot be thing should be satisfied there. Cannot be insulted. So poverty, miserable. The people who are miserable are often in poverty. So even this is not the right answer. Purchase and sell, these are opposite words. This is not the right answer. This is not the answer according to our analogy. Assault, impregnable. What is impregnable? Impregnable means the people who can't be chained, the people who can't be captured, who cannot be captured, who are very powerful, cannot be captured or cannot be broken, or the thing which cannot be broken. So those things or those people are said to be impregnable. So if the person is impregnable, then it is you cannot assault him. Assault ka matlab kya? Atyachar. You cannot assault him. So this is the right analogy between these two words. So insult and invulnerable has same analogy as assault and impregnable. Sorry, insult and invulnerable has same analogy as assault and impregnable. Next question, impeach, dismiss. So if you have read the Indian polity, then you might be knowing the meaning of this word, impeach. Impeach means it is the word which is used for removal of president from his office. So if you want to remove the president from his office for any wrongdoings that he has done, then the impeachment process should be undertaken in the parliament. So dismiss is removing someone from the office. So both are one and the same. So you have to find the meaning between the words. So let's check for options. So D, imprison. Imprison means putting some criminal in prison. And police means police is the people who put criminals in the prison. So there is no meaning between these two words. Exact meaning between these two words. We want the exact meaning between these two words. But the meaning of imprison is different from police. So disregard this option. Plant, reap. Plant is first stage of cropping. Reap is the last stage of cropping. So there is no exact meaning between these two words. They are the process, first stage, last stage of the process of cropping. So this is not the answer. Exonerate. So exonerate means release someone from the duty or remove from someone from the duty. Charge means the person who take charge of something or join the duty. So these are opposite in meaning. So this is not the answer. The answer is A. What is arraign? Bring some criminal to the court. So bringing criminal to the court for justice. To court for justice. So even indict is providing justice. Providing justice. Here also, some criminal is brought to the court in order to provide justice. So arraign is also indicating providing justice. Indict is also indicating providing justice. So A is the answer. Next question. Law, citizen. So what is the analogy between these two words? What basically law does is law restricts the citizen from wrongdoing. It restricts the citizen from doing wrong things. From doing wrong things. So let us see the restriction part. Weapon, peace. From by taking weapon in your hand, what does it lead to? It leads to war, not peace. So this is not the right answer. So what I am basically trying to explain is through law we are doing something good. So restricting the citizen from wrongdoings is nothing but doing something good for the society. Okay. Second, democracy and communist. Democracy is one ideology and communist is another ideology. There is no link between these two. So disregard this option. Tyranny and despot, both are nothing but autocratic rule. For example, Hitler's rule, it was an autocratic rule. It also restricted the freedom of citizen. This also restricts the freedom of citizen. But it is doing in the wrong way. It is not doing for the betterment of the citizen. The freedom is restricted for the selfish purpose of that autocratic ruler. For example, Hitler. So he was an autocratic ruler, or his rule was despotic, because he wanted the whole of Europe. He wanted to capture the whole of Europe for his selfish needs, not for the betterment of the citizens of his country. So this is used in a negative sense, and that is why we can't take this option. Reins and horse. What is reins? Reins is a belt which is tied to the face of horse. If this is the horse face, so it is tied to the horse face so that the horse doesn't deviate its path. It should not deviate its path. That's why the belt is used on the horse face to show it a proper path. And this is done for the good purpose. And this explains the analogy. So law restricts the citizen from wrongdoing, from doing the wrong things. Reins restrict the moment of the horse from deviating from its path. So this is the right analogy. Next question. Emulate. Emulate means imitating somebody. Imitate. So mimic also means imitate. So you have to find the synonyms between the words. Aggressive, lessen. Aggressive is showing more energy. Lessen means showing less energy. So these are opposite in meaning. Praise, sorry, see. Aggravate, promote. Aggravate means worsening something, making a bad thing worse. Promote means it's a good thing. Promoting somebody, promoting an officer from group B post to group A post. So it's a good thing. So these are opposite in meaning. That's why I disregard this. Express, imply. Express means expressing something, expressing your feelings, for example. Imply means implying something. It implies that I have done the homework. So implying is something different and expressing is something different. They don't belong to the same category. So disregard this. The answer is B. Praise and flatter. Both are one and the same. Praising somebody. This also indicates praising somebody. One is in good sense and another thing is in negative sense. But praising is the thing which is happening here. In both the case, praising is the thing which is happening here. So praise and flatter holds good with the analogy emulate and mimic. Next question, celebrate marriage. So where do you celebrate? You celebrate. When do you celebrate? You celebrate when there is somebody's marriage or when you are marrying. At that time you celebrate. So let's find the similar analogy. Bedroom, window. Window is no doubt a part of bedroom, but this will not explain the analogy. That is, we celebrate during marriages. No. Let's take C. Pot, pan. So these are two different things used for housework. So this is not the analogy. Face, penalty. So face is face of a person. Penalty is the price which you pay for wrongdoings. So this is not the analogy. The answer is B. Why? What is bereavement? So bereavement means something bad that has happened to a person. Something bad has happened to a person. That is bereavement. So what is lament? Lament is a person who is in sorrow. A person who is in sorrow or grief. So when something bad happens to a person, no, at that time he'll be in grief. So this analogy explains the analogy of celebrate and marriage. When do you celebrate? When there is a marriage, when there is a reason to celebrate. So marriage is one of the reason to celebrate. So when will you be upset or when you will be in sorrow? When something bad has happened to you. So this is how it explains the analogy. Next question, gland, enzymes. So what is gland? Gland are group of cells in our body which generates chemical substances called enzymes. Which generates chemical substances called enzymes. And these enzymes has different function in our body. So what we can find here is gland is a place where enzymes are produced. So let us find for such analogies. Muscle, spasm. So muscle means the muscle of a body. Spasm means muscle contraction, pain in our body. So this is not the analogy. Organ, kidney. So kidney is one of the organ in our body, but this is not showing that it is generating something or some kind. So this is not the analogy. Brain, context, this is not the analogy because it is not showing any generation of a substance. This is the answer. B, generator, current. So what does generator do? It generator produces or generates current. So this is the right analogy. Stutter, speech. What is stutter? Stutter is nothing but defect in speech. So it is a defect in speech. You might have seen Golmaal 3. In Golmaal 3, there is a person called Lakshman, and he used to speak like this. He used to stutter. So that is the defect in speech. So let's find the similar analogy. Blare, hearing. Blare means harsh sound. So it doesn't indicate any defect in hearing. So this is not the answer. Aroma, smelling. Aroma is pleasant smell. So here also we don't find any defect. Novocaine, touch. Novocaine is a type of chemical, and touch is touching, and this also doesn't indicate any relationship. Astigmatism, sight. This is the right answer. What is astigmatism? Astigmatism happens when there is some problem in the eye, in the lens of your eye. When there is some problem in the lens of your eye, then astigmatism happens. Astigmatism is nothing but defective eyesight. So astigmatism is defective eyesight, and this is the right answer. And this analogy holds good with stutter and speech. These are some of the practice questions. These are also confusing ones. So attempt these questions. I think there are 10 questions. So attempt these questions and comment your answers in the comment section. I'll be giving the answers in the next video. So the one thing is that in the examination, first thing is you have to know the meaning of the word. For that, you should know the antonyms, synonyms, one word substitution, idioms of the words and all. I'll be making the separate video for antonyms, synonyms, one word substitution, idioms and phrases in my English lecture series, that is Rules of English Grammar. So stay tuned with the channel and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.